I really wanted it to feel like how the old Barbies looked. I didn't grow up on the old Barbies, obviously, but they're just the coolest thing in the world. Vintage Barbie is like some of the coolest stuff ever. What was I made for? Yeah, it was really fun to like make the mood board for it. Like I just pictured desk, chair, sage green, blonde ponytail, yellow outfit, and the dress is perfect. My mom's mom, who I never met, my grandma, she used to make clothes for my mom, and they were very cute, and a couple of them she still had when I was a kid, and I would wear them, and they were like just the sweetest little, you know, cute little square with buttons mod dresses, and I was picturing those. Oh, it should shake first, like there's a little earthquake, and then it should be windy, and then it should be rain. What was I made for? Part of what's hard about directing is, especially when you're someone like me that like, I don't know much about cameras. I just have these ideas and I think that I know how to execute them.
More,
just
the
so
hair.
That I'm like struggling more and like have more to do, you know?
Yeah.
So, and the initial burst is great though. Cool. But then right after that, just having just more
dynamics. Yeah, move it around.
Thanks guys.
And I knew I wanted it to be one shot. And that was an issue to begin with. Especially when you're like, I want there to be wind and then I want it to rain all over me and I want to be wearing a really intricate wig and have a bunch of little miniature clothes. And then talk to Pat, my DP. He really nailed what I was telling him. I was like, okay, I want it to feel really gritty. We were talking 16 millimeter. I don't know if that's gonna be even grainy enough. I think it will be. If it's a one take or similar to a one take, I'll do my own version in the yard and they're so stupid. And I made a little mock-up of how I wanted them. All the camera movements are specific to the lyrics. And then a big note was like, I didn't want the camera to be moving around or following me if I go off screen or whatever, because the camera is just filming and I happen to be there. So like if something blows off the table and I run off screen to get it, that the camera doesn't even notice. I don't know. I don't know how to feel, but I wanna try. I don't know, just thought of like the ones that I feel have been the most seen, that the fans were drawn to the most. Or like the ones from like big moments in my life. So like the bellyache one, the Grammys outfit, when the party's over with the black, the crown, the lovely outfit, this little yellow camo outfit that I wore a bunch, the bad guy yellow outfit, like Dapper Dan looks from SNL, one of the first shirts that I ever sold, which was really cute. All the little shoes. There's the little choker that I wore in the Vanity Fair video. It was hard though, because there's so many that we could have put in, but we could only do like a certain amount. You know, it's all these past versions of myself that are me, and they're also not me because they're different versions of me, but they'll always be me. And it's just thinking about your life and the present and the past is, and the future is a scary and gut-wrenching thing to do. Something I'm
made for. The Human Footsteps.
Yay!
I think we have it, guys.